I'm Matt Harrington, I'm an EFCO field supervisor, and today's toolbox talk revolves around how to properly set a rugged taper tie. Right here's one of EFCO's 48-inch taper ties. Here is one of our wing nuts. The good thing about these ties is it takes the same size wing nut at each end, so you only have two different parts. The first step with figuring your dimension for your wall is to measure the length of your taper tie. Right here you can see that we are at 49 inches. And the width of our wall is 24 inches. The width of the form is 8.5. And the width of the wing nut is 2.5. So if you double the wall, that's gonna give us 17 inches, and double the wing nut for one on each side is 5 inches. So 24 inches plus 17 plus 5 equals 46 inches. So we're gonna subtract 46 from our 49, and that gives us 3 inches of tie that's left. Divide that number by 2, and that's going to give us how much tie should be sticking out on each side of our wall. First step is to put the wing nut onto the end of your tie. We'll go ahead and measure down, make sure we're set at 1.5 inches, and we are. And then the next step is to insert your tie into the wall. Last but not least, you want to make sure that you've set your tie correctly. And right here, we have 1.5 inches sticking out, so our tie is set properly. And do a quick visual inspection to make sure that all your ties have the same amount sticking out past the wing nut. What this will do is it will ensure that you have a wall that's going to turn out a proper uniform thickness. Also, by having them all set evenly like this, it'll ensure that you don't cast any threads of your tie inside of your wall, so that way it'll allow for quick, easy removal of your taper tie. It's always recommended to clean and oil your ties between every pour, and then also remove them 24 hours, or at least crack them loose 24 hours after your pour. If you get any concrete spillage on the threads are a really aggressive thread, so when you go to remove the wing nut, the ties are also self-cleaning, which is another added feature. For ready radius tanks, we always recommend setting the fat end of the taper tie to the inside of the tank. It'll always allow all the pressure to push against the rubber plug, which will always tighten the plug and keep any of the liquid from the tank from leaking out of your tie hole. This concludes today's toolbox talk on how to properly set a taper tie. For any further information, please contact your EFCO field supervisor or look us up on YouTube.